So for our audience, please explain what the Ligō device is. I know it's a 3D printing platform, and it's being used to print human tissue. Is that right?
Yes, that's correct. Ligō is an in-situ robotically assisted bioprinting device that's been designed for use at point of care for full thickness skin injuries.
Yeah, and it uses the core technology that you developed for our RASM platform, but now it's, you know, as originally in part of our vision, it's going to convert the technology that was initially used for medical research into a clinical application.
Is this one of the first robots to be able to use the point of care? Because typically the 3D printing technology for tissue has been in a sort of a highly sterile controlled environment.
Yes, that's right. Traditionally it's been used in to basically tissue engineer, not at point of care, but in this instance, we are able to print a patient's own cells encapsulated in our hydrogel biomaterials directly into the wound so that we can mimic the tissue environment and accelerate skin regeneration and reduce scarring.
What was the genesis of this technology originally? It usually will come out of, I've not heard of using the patient's own cells before. Are we able to propagate those pretty quickly? What does that process look like?
That process, basically we take a donor site, a split thickness skin graft typically, a very small donor site. We dissociate the healthy skin cells from that donor sample, and we mix those with our biomaterials, which are loaded into the robotic printing device. And then we use a non-contact printing technology to deposit those directly back into the wound site.
What we're doing is we add the cells from the patient, the extracellular matrix, the part that the fabric that's maintain the skin integrity, means that we can help the cells accelerate it, the healing of the wound. Hmm.
That's very exciting. So what would be the immediate patient population that we'd be attending to as we develop this technology?
The immediate population would be patients that has wounds, severe wound injuries, where they need very fast and quick covering of the wound, for example, burn victims, where then they can have, because the time of the cover of the wound is extremely critical for the patient's health and recovery. And that's probably the initial target that we see.
And what is the use of the KUKA robotic arm complement or help with this platform? What could you share with me there?
So the KUKA arm is a really critical component in our platform that really allows us to perform the bioprinting in a very safe and controlled way at the point of care. Without that component, we wouldn't be able to develop the technology and the platform as quickly as we have.
What does it mean to each of you to be nominated as a finalist for the KUKA Innovation Award?
Well, we received this as an endorsement that we are using the technology on the right way, that we are taking the advantage of what KUKA has created and add to it an innovative way of treating patients. Means that it has speed up the process, and this award is acknowledgement of that what we're doing is innovative and very advanced. Mm-hmm. And that's for the whole team at Inventure that has been put a lot of energy and work on this. This acknowledgement is extremely important.
Yeah, we've also been developing the Ligō platform for the last number of years, and we're very excited about this, about the KUKA Innovation Award and the Medica Trade Fair, as this will be the first public unveiling of the platform